Hi, my name is Jessica and I want to thank you for joining me in the Dollhouse. Today is my very first video upload, so I brought someone special to unbox with you today. I have Harmonique of MGA Entertainment's Mermaids. Let's dive in. Harmonique is one of five mermaids set to be released in series one of Mermaids. The mermaids will feature Harmonique, Jordy, Riviera, Shelnel, and Kishiko. Harmonique is a pop star performer and no spotlight's enough. Harmonique has an amazing singing voice and always looks glamorous in the spotlight. Even though Harmonique has a massive fan base, she knows there's always room for other mermaids to shine too. These dolls were originally set to be released for pre-order on February 18th and to be released in stores on March 1st. Unfortunately, these dates were changed last minute. These dolls will be released March 29th for pre-order and April 4th in stores. You're probably wondering, how did I get her? I was able to purchase her on eBay and I did pay ridiculously for her. I don't know how they got her, but I did see her on the Walmart website recently. She's retailing for $32.99 and I did purchase a second one. She should be here by this Tuesday. Let's unbox Harmonique and see what the deal is, and let's see this water transformation in person. So Harmonique is free from her box, and let's check out her little details. And this doll is beautiful in person. Honestly, I'm not a real big fan of the standing tail because it wasn't exactly easy to get her in this standing position. I had to adjust her a little bit and move her head, hair over her shoulder, but I guess that's to be expected. But besides that, let's go over her details. So she has the rooted eyelashes, the pink and black eyeliner. Oh, her eyeshadow is a silver pink and a burgundy pink. She has white and black eyeliner. She has the rooted eyelashes and inset eyes. She has like pouty, I'm gonna blow a bubble lips. I don't know. Let me show you her face up close. She has that very nice accessories, like her earrings, her headset, the necklace, the choker, and it comes off easily from what I'm seeing. There's like a break in the back. These rubber hair pieces, I was kind of curious when I seen her online and in the box what the texture that was. Again, there's like a break in the upper piece to where you can just slide this one off. And these are like a thick silver rubber band material. So I believe it's optional if you want to take these off. They should be able to go back on. I'm going to leave mine on. She has her pop star crop top, which is lovely. And she has her puff shoulders. She's also wearing her corset, which is studded with gemstones. Or artificial stones with an aurora borealis effect, which is not catching very well on the camera, but it's really pretty in person. And these, it has a metallic rainbow effect on her fanny pack purse. This has a chain attachment to it. And no, this is just for decoration. This does not open. There's nothing that can be stored in here. But it's cute. And it's attached with Velcro. Here. And here. And her blouse and bustier or corset are attached with Velcro as well. Her purse is not bendy. It's a hard plastic. And it has a shell here, but these parts are, her handles are movable
And she's about to fall. Let me try to stand her up. This is like my balance aspect. I'll set her purse down. She has ring accessories that are not removable. Her hands are really delicate and pretty. Oh, like, they look really nice. Like, she's got mermaid hands. She has a bracelet on, which is also attached. Show them the rocks. She's fancy. So I would also like to remove her accessories and see what's underneath her top, at least. So let's do it. And I'm liking this prism effect with her tail. And her fan is really pretty. And this is movable. Moves all the way back. Moves forward just to this point. I do wish, just like everyone else, that she had articulation in her fin or in her, or like a joint of her fins where it wouldn't affect functionality. She can bend some at the waist. But just some. She has a belt here as well. This can be removed. Now I'm gonna take off her corset. Her instructions tell you how you can remove her hands, but I'm positive is sort of like the Rainbow High dolls, and they are. It came off pretty easy with a gentle twist. Twist, twist. I'm gonna take off her top. Okay, this is how I'm gonna take her top off. And it's, her bracelet is here. Okay, it's still coming off pretty well. I was concerned. And this is what she looks like. Oop, let me get her hands back on. Push. Push. Okay. Let's get her in a mermaid-esque pose. I guess that's a mermaid-esque pose. Just really, really pretty hands. So here she is. She move here. Ooh. She can move her wrists. She's jointed here, or, you know, flexible here at her bust, and her waist is pretty movable as well, so she is poseable. You know, her head, we can go left and right. Can she move up and down? No, that must be a feature to come later, like how Rainbow High did. We didn't have the up and down action yet until later. I'm surprised though. But she's pretty. I do love her. Kishiko is really the doll that I was really amped up for and still am. She's my winner because I am a huge fan of mermaid dolls. They are my favorite. Mermaids are my favorite. I'm a Disney girl. And obviously, the Little Mermaid is my favorite princess. Kishiko gives me more of the fantasy vibes. She has a fantasy color. She has a more classic tail. Her hair is very colorful. And that's the one I'm probably going to buy a couple duplicates of. I'm just looking at the details of her rings. And her jewelry. And her face. She's a very beautiful doll. And I tried to copy your hairstyle. How'd I do? So I know you want to see her color change. And I have not a special fantasy mermaid pool, but I have this bowl that I found in the kitchen. Let's see this color transformation. And I do not want to get her hair wet. So let's dip her towel. I believe she changes in warm water. Wow. That was quick. Give them the business. Wow. Okay. Let's dip her again. I want to get the whole thing in there and I don't want to get her hair wet. I'm having a little bit of trouble. No, I'm not, but maybe that's not supposed to. Okay. If I could have dipped her better. Next time I'll get a bigger bowl. Oh, she's changing back already. Hold on now. Like, this water's hot, yo. Is the back not supposed to change? Oh, I guess the back doesn't change. Or maybe it changed from blue to pink. I don't know. But she's in there. And this is our transformation. Let's get that water out. That's pretty. I'm seeing it on the camera and it's pretty. That's the back still. And the front. That's pretty. And it drained pretty well too, I think. And that's our girl, Harmonique. Well, if you like this video, please like and subscribe. I have so much more coming. I'm a crafty girl. I have repaints that I have planned. I have diagrammas that I plan on doing. And of course, some more doll reviews. Thank you for joining me in the dollhouse, and please come back soon. Bye.